to fight the war against ISIS, get fucking kill them all. Listen, ISIS are a pack of murderers, you know what I mean? They're fucking, they can't be talked out of anything. They're committed, they're gonna run around fucking killing everybody, which pretty much gives the rest of the world a green light to murder the fuck clean out of them. I mean, people hear that brainwashed, you know, it's a guilt-free killing, you know what I mean? It's like killing a fucking zombie. You'd be sitting there eating your lunch, stand up, put a fucking spade through a zombie's head, and then sit back down to the lasagna like fucking nothing ever happened, you know what I mean? Sleep like a baby. Suppose you'll probably get my fucking head hacked off on YouTube for saying that sort of shit. Honestly, you couldn't give a fuck, to be honest. Put that there. Nice as that shit.
My name's Marty, and job is full-time player, part-time in the leisure centre. I'm really actually looking for somebody special, somebody who listens, somebody you can get to know, somebody who's honest, and just somebody with big, massive ditties. My celebrity crush would definitely have to be Anthony Turner, from GMTV. Because GMTV, what does that stand for? Good morning trouble. Major turn off. Just some girl who's frigid. Put her or get her. So that's it from me, Marty. If you want to get in touch with me, send me a fax or a page or whatever, and I'll go for them.
Here, lads! Lads! Trash in your grandparents that won't be here forever! Forever!
Sure you do yourself, anyway.
So this morning I wake up feeling rougher than a tattooed female darts player from East Belfast. What happened last night? Don't even chat to me, bro. Me, McElroy and G-Mac went out for a Saturday stout session and it was absolutely Lionel. Messy. Lionel Messy. We head into Ollie's, obviously the VIP booth's already waiting. They call me the cloakroom, we've got that many hookups. Banter. Not tonight, lads, the bouncer says, trying to have a bit of banter. So I smack him and get him sacked. Was that not a bit much, mate? Was that not a bit much, mate? Says McDowell. Shut up, Graham, I say. Hope you brought your rifle, mate, because you're about to go hunting for goose. He has no idea what I mean. Go and get me and McElroy some drinks, you bloody chancer. So, me and McElroy sitting in VIP like the two swarthy North Down gents that we are. A massive group of birds obviously come over. And they're like, oh my god, you're the best golfer in the world. And I go, hey, McElroy's here as well, so. At this point, McDowell comes back with the drinks. Go away, Graham. Yeah, we're trying to talk to some birds, McElroy adds. Anyway, the birds say, come back to ours, boys, for a nightcap. We've got a suite in the Aruba. So we're walking through the hotel foyer, and I say quietly, McElroy, I think the wee redhead likes you there, mate. And he says, but Mike, there's 19 birds. What's going to happen with the rest of them? And I said, leave it to me, McElroy. Wouldn't be the first time I'd played a round of 18 holes. All I'm going to say is the next day we got taxis back to the Gold Coast with smiles bigger than Kim Kardashian's arse.
Would you look at that fat-headed bitch, you think she's better than everyone else? Oh fuck me, Julian, she's looking back this way!
But now on the UTV, it's time for Cribs.
Hello again, it's me, Rodney. I'm going to show you around my new holiday house. As you can see here, this is a mini fridge, I think it's called. I think it's for the dwarf that used to live here. Just have a break. Have a £14 Kit Kat. What else we got here? Got a big TV, got a big TV there, love. Watching TV, mummy's not here. I've got a big light up here. As you can see, you've got a big light. Looks like a crystal ball. But can't predict my future. You're going to be a virgin? I'm not going to be a virgin. Stop it. Don't lie.
I always pick to go away, so I do in November. Yeah, I always pick to go away in November because it's a lot cheaper. I got it for £30. It's pissed down for the past 3 weeks, but you can't beat £30, can you? Well, I suppose £20, but this is my big giant bed. That's where I sleep. That's where my mummy would have slept. If she came with me, but mummy didn't come with me on this trip, and just probably couldn't be bothered wallpapering, so they just framed some wallpaper. Because I miss my mummy so much. She lets me bring a picture of her with me every time we come to the hotel, so it's good that I can always be with her and just look at her when I'm trying to sleep or touching myself. This is a picture of my daddy. He's narcoleptic, so I have to keep our voices down when we're in here. So as you can see, this here is my bathroom. This is where I keep all my things in here. There's, as you can see, my Vaseline, like we're not putting on lips sometimes when the lips are packed. Very nice. This here again, that's where the machines in there. And then what's that wee toilet thing? I've got like two toilets, a wee small one. It's my B-day. Why is there no presents on it?
Here, lad! Good on you, keeping our city clean! It's looking sparkling! Sparkling!
MC Beezer, back at you. Can I get a rewind? Sound effects, rewind. Right, you know the drill. Hit me with a word. Let's go. Let's do this. Let's get this locked down.
Ebola.
Fucking kick his bollocks and he's got Ebola. Ebola is a disease. If I got it, I would not be pleased. I'd be on my knees, going, please, get me a doctor. Even if he has to come by a tractor. X Factor.